Hi, I'm George Pearson, and in this video we'll be doing a Photoshop color change. As you can see right here on her jacket, there we go. Now if you like this video, make sure you hit that like button, and of course share, and also subscribe if you haven't already done so. And take a look at my complete training course for Photoshop, and there's a link for that right down there in the description. Okay, let's get to it. The basic idea behind doing this kind of a color change in here, just like that, is to make a selection of just the area you want to change, and then using an adjustment layer here, a hue saturation layer, apply that onto that one layer so it's just showing that particular area. Now there are lots of different ways of making selections. You could take your time in here and do a real careful selection around the figure in here. And depending upon what you're doing, some ways may work better than others. In this case, we have all this hair coming over this jacket, so it's better if we use a different technique and if we can select the color, because of course the color is pretty distinct in here. There's some red over here, there's some red down there, and there's some red back there. Aside from those spots, this is pretty separate from everything else. So we can use a special tool up in the select menu up there to select just for the color range that's shown in this jacket. But to do this right, there are a few tricks that can make this turn out a lot better. Okay, let me just go over here. I'm going to delete all these layers that we don't need on the right-hand side over here. Let's just hit the delete button on that, and we'll get rid of those layers. There we go. And back to just the basic background. Now for this, I'm going to make a duplicate of the background. I do this anyway all the time just as a safety precaution. So I'm just going to right-click this time and duplicate layer and choose OK. There we go. We can then hide that background. We'll make our selection on this layer here. Now the tool I'm talking about under select is this one right here, color range, and allows you to select for a specific color range. Now it chooses the color range over the whole image, so we'll have to do some cleanup on this after we get the basic color range selected. So here's the color range right there. And what you do is you use the eyedropper over here and then sample a specific color in the image. And it's going to then select everything that's that color. Anything that selects will be in white, as you can see here. Anything that's not selecting is in black. Things that are coming in different levels of transparency will be different levels of gray. So we'll find a spot right here on the jacket. That was pretty good right in there. Look for a good mid-tone area if you can. And that should give you a pretty good selection. Now we can look at the selection in here as grayscale, or as a black matte. Notice we can see some gray spots in here. Now this might be a good one to use on this one. Or we could do a white matte like that. Again, we can see where there's some holes in here. Or the quick mask. The view technique you use will depend upon what your needs are and if you want to go in and double check. We'll start off with the grayscale. What I want in here is as much pure white as I can get. So here's our basic selection. We know that the jacket is all that kind of reddish color, but I want to add in these gray areas into that white selection. So go over here, and we have these three eyedroppers. We use the first one to get the basic selection. Let's now move to this plus sign, and with this I can click on other areas in here, and it adds those into the selection. Notice as I add in more areas in here, I'm also beginning to pick up more stuff in the background. We'll need to clean that stuff out later on. But I'll go through here. I'm just going to click on a few spots in here and try to get as much of this converted over to white as possible. Of course, I don't care about the buttons. They're just fine. And just click around and get this as pure white as we can get it. And that's pretty good. Let's just check this other side over here. That looks fine. Again, there's a lot of stuff in here we'll have to clean out. But we should have a good selection now on the jacket. You can adjust the fuzziness in here, and this is going to allow you to kind of fine-tune that background out. So I'll just pull this down a little bit, and let's see if we can get a few more of these spots in here. And that's looking probably about as close as I'm going to be getting on this one. There we go. You can also adjust the range. This is how far it's going away from the color you selected. Notice as I pull this further, I begin to lose the jacket in there as well. I found a higher setting tends to work out best, at least it does for me on this. Now this isn't perfect, and this will require some cleanup on the mask afterwards. Also, notice up here we have detect faces. We don't care about that for this, obviously, because we're doing a jacket. And we have localized color clusters. If I uncheck that, notice it grabs a lot more color from surrounding areas. So make sure that is checked to keep this as accurate as possible. Okay, I think we're about as good as we can get now on this. It's then going to convert this into a selection. There we go. And here's a little marching ants selection. We can clean a lot up right now. Anything that has marching ants that you don't want, we'll just remove those from the selection. So I'll grab the standard lasso tool over here and I'll choose the remove or delete from or subtract from option right there. And then just do a big circle around anything you want to get rid of. It will then delete that from your basic selections. It's real easy and quick cleanup in here. I can't get right by that finger yet. Now, let's get a bit closer this time. There we go. Looks pretty good. It's a little bit right in here. Let me just get that out of there. And the jacket is right here. So I'm just going to follow up along the curve of the jacket there and around to my start point again. And a few things in the face here. We can get rid of those pretty easily. Okay, that looks pretty good. There's a lot of things in here that aren't selected that I want to have selected. We can use or fix those, of course, with the other option over here. But first, I just noticed some fingers right there. Let me just clean that out. Okay, go over to the Add To selection. And then where you see marching ants inside of your selection, just do a circle around those. And those will then add those into the selection. Go around here. And just a little cleanup. Now I have to do even more than this as we get further in. We need to clean out some stuff inside the mask. The mask is not going to come in as a solid mask. And there are some things you can do to improve that as well. So this is just our first step on the cleanup. This will cut down how much has to be done later on. Okay, just looking through, seeing if there's any more little marching ants in here. We'll take care of those quickly. And that little spot right there as well. And a little bit right there. Okay, that looks pretty good. Maybe a bit right in there. And now we can convert this to a layer mask. We have our selection. We're on our copy of our layer up here. So just hit the layer mask button. Gives you a layer mask, and there it is. Now you can already see there's some problems in it. There's a few holes showing through here. You can see those. And we have some stuff in the background in there that's kind of showing through. You can get rid of that. It's pretty easy to see here. Let's make it even easier to see. You can just put a white layer behind this. Come down to the background layer. Let's just add a new layer here. I'll fill it with white. Let's put our colors there to false, invert, and paint bucket in a white layer. That's just in behind there. We can really now see anything that's kind of transparent that's showing through. You can get rid of this by painting black on the layer mask. So click the layer mask side. Look for the outline. When you're working with a layer mask, black hides and white shows. So here's our brush. It's pretty small. Let's bring our brush size up. That's good. And then just paint black right onto the layer mask itself, and that will hide all of this stuff. This is our second pass on our cleanup. We'll be doing a third pass as well. In each one of these passes, I just do it where it's easiest to do it, which will make the process go as fast as possible. I've never seen a perfect layer mask come out, so you always have to do some cleanup on layer masks. But this is pretty good. Actually, we're very, very close on this one. Okay, that looks good. Let's just double check this real fast here. There's a few more little things in close that we'll have to touch up, and we can get those and see those better by going right to the layer mask itself. So go over here, layer mask side, hold the Alt key down and click on the layer mask. This takes you right into the layer mask itself. We can kind of see a lot of stuff in here. Now one thing you see right there, so there's a real white area and it's gray out here. That means that the layer mask isn't as white as it should be. We want to have this pure white. So I'm going to adjust the contrast in here on the layer mask. Go up to Image, come down to Adjustment, Brightness and Contrast. And just push the contrast clear to the right and brightness clear to the right. And that cleans up most of that. It also makes the edges jaggy in here. We'll fix that in just a bit. So that takes care of that. Much better looking layer mask. We can now see these little spots underneath clean up on the outside. Now again, black hides, white shows. So here's our paintbrush. I'm in pretty close on this. I'm going to change this to a soft edge brush. Actually to a hard edge. There we go, hard edge round. And I'll come down pretty small. That's good. Now it's a matter of going around the edge and catching any little things that's showing outside the edge. Don't worry about the actual edge itself. Just get things that are just outside and we'll clean those out. There we go. Just work clear around. A little bit right down here and right there. And if you hold the space bar down, you can then move this around just by pushing it with the space bar. And a little bit of cleanup again. I'm looking for anything which is showing out here. There's not much. Looks like we're pretty good. Oh, a lot of stuff down here. Okay, let's get this all cleaned out. Since we're working towards a reddish color, this will be reddish tones in her flesh tones on her leg. So, should have expected that. But as you can see, real easy to clean up on the layer mask. Just paint it out with black right on the layer mask. Okay, that looks good. I'll just pull it down again. A little bit here, a little bit on the edge of the skirt right there. And just looking around, I'm not really seeing anything over here. A little bit right there. Right in here, a little bit right there. And right up here. It's looking pretty good though. A little bit right in there. And then just a bit in here, inside around the collar area. Okay, so that looks nice. Let's now reverse this and clean up anything inside. Now, don't do anything with the hair. That's all as it should be. I'll just reverse my colors. And we're looking for any black spots in the white area that shouldn't be there. Those are all buttons, so we'll leave those alone. Just a few little things right there. Leave that one alone. A little spot right there. Okay, that looks good. Now we have this hard edge. We can solve that hard edge issue by softening up the layer mask. Go to the filter menu, come down to blur and use the Gaussian blur. Here's without and there's with. There's a little bit of preview on that. And that just softens up that just a little bit and choose OK. And that should give us a clean layer mask. Let's go back to fit screen. Okay, a couple things right up here. And at the very top, need to fix those, and then we're all set. So back to black since we're hiding, grab our paintbrush, and let's just quickly paint those little spots out. There we go. Real fast layer mask cleanup in here. I could go for a larger brush size, but I don't want to take the extra time just to do that, since that's all we're doing is just that little bit. Okay, looks excellent. Now hold the Alt key down and click on that layer mask again, and you're back to our look. Here it is. Let's now hide the white layer and show our background. And now we're ready for the color change. That was the hard part right there. Once you have that layer mask done, that's all the difficult stuff. Now just add an adjustment layer here. Layer, new adjustment layer, hue saturation. Where it says use previous layer to create clipping mask, make sure that is selected. That will then apply the adjustment just to this layer here with the layer mask. Now all you have to do is just move the slider control to give yourself any color you want on that jacket. There's kind of a nice mustardy yellow right there. That actually looks very, very good at this picture. That's a nice one. Here is some nice blues. Now sometimes you'll find a color you may want to use, like right here, where you're losing a little bit of contrast in there. So if you're losing some contrast in your shadows, most of these look pretty good. Most of them have nice contrast range, but that blue one there, it's just a little low on the contrast. If you're doing that, if you're going for that particular color range where you're losing your contrast, easy to fix, we'll just use a second adjustment layer. So layer, new adjustment layer, and this time do a levels adjustment. And again, check that checkbox right there, choose OK, and then just bring your blacks up a bit until you bring back in the contrast that you want for that. And that looks pretty nice right in there. Okay, let's just take a look. There's our beginning and here's our finish right there. And there it is. As you can see, it's a real nice tool. And again, that's up here, select, and that's that color range tool right there. Real nice tool if you want to select out a specific color range that's pretty separate from anything else in your background, in your picture. So if you have that kind of a situation, it's a great tool to use to make a very nice layer mask. And again, there's our cleaned up and completed layer mask. Okay, so that's how you change colors in here, changing the color on this clothing by using a layer mask on a layer and that color range, which is under the select menu. Now, if you enjoyed this video, make sure you hit that like button. Also click on share as well and subscribe. You can also support my channel through Patreon. There's a link for Patreon on the channel page. And take a look at my complete training course for Photoshop, and there's a link right down there in the description.